Near the end of the 19th century, the German mathematician Cantor proved Cantor's theorem using Cantor's diagonal argument. And Cantor's theorem is, of course, that there are infinitely many infinities. So, well, on to the next question. The final kind of video I would like to show you is the how-to video, or some call it an instruction video also. And I have a pretty good idea for something I'll show you there, so let's just do it. Hi, today I would like to show you how to do a card trick I invented myself. I'm dividing this video into two parts. The first part is where I show you the card trick, and the second part is where I tell you how you could do it yourself. So let's just start the first part. Hi, I'm the Lone Gnu, and I would like to play a game with you. Okay? So, we got some cards here. And as you can see, they are pretty good shuffled, right? So, but, well, you probably don't believe me, so let's just shuffle them some more. I'll just take off some cards, and then you'll stop me when we're about halfway through, okay? Is that fine? Or no? Let's take some more. Okay, that's about halfway through. Let's just say that's fine. Great. So what we do here is we take and shuffle them together. Okay, so let's play a little game. I'll turn over two cards, and if you get two spades, or even two black cards actually, then you win. And let's just say you win on two red cards too. So if it's a black and a red, or a red and a black, then I win, okay? So let's try that. So the first two, a club and a heart, that's a black and a red, I win. Let's try again. Yes, again. And again. And again. Okay, I might have okay odds, this like half chance of me winning every time. That's too good odds for me. I needed to get a bit more difficult. So let's say we take four cards at a time. And this time I can only win if there's one club, one spade, one heart, and one diamond. All other possibilities, not necessarily in that order, but yeah, one of each. And all other possibilities, you win, okay? So let's just see that. Four cards. There's a club, a diamond, a spade, and a heart. Okay, I win. Let's just do it again for good measure. Diamond, spades, club, heart, spades, club, diamond. I win again. Okay, so now I'm going to go all in because this is I'm on the lucky streak, so I believe I can do even better. So I'll just take and yeah, it's too easy to take from the top of the deck, so I think I'll take from the bottom of the deck this time, and I'll take 13 cards. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13. So here, this time I win if these cards contain one ace, one two, one three, one four, and so up until the king, one of each number. One of each type of card. So that's really, really unlikely that it will happen. But I bet you it'll happen. So we have a 10, 7, 5, jack, ace. Let's just put an ace here. 5 here. 4, 9, 3, have to be able to see them. We have a 3 there, 5, yeah, 6, should be here, 8, king, 2, and queen. And I will claim that you actually get the same if you take the next 13 card again. Let's just put these away and see if we have 13 cards here. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13, yes, good. 6, 8, king, 2, 10, 7. Let's just put it like this again. 5, queen, jack, ace, 3, 4, 9. So again, we have all of them. So now I'll show you how to do the card trick yourself. As you can imagine, it requires some preparation. But all you actually need of props is one totally normal deck of cards. So this is really just a normal deck of cards. No tricks, anything. And you remove the jokers. That's the first thing. The next thing is you take the cards and put them on the table in 13 piles. One pile for each number. Okay. And the order of the cards here doesn't really matter. Except if you want, it matters a little bit because you should actually make sure that they're not in order. It should look random. It should look like they're in totally mixed order. Right now you have like 3 and 4 after each other and 5 and 6 after each other. So maybe we should like switch these two around or something like that. Then it looks a bit more random. It doesn't make any difference for how the trick will work, but it does make a difference if you do this, showing the way they are shuffled. They will look a bit less random when you show them to the audience. So this is the first part. I'll just quickly do that. So now we've got them divided into piles, one for each kind of card. Okay. The next thing is we need to order them according to the suit. So we have 3 columns here, and each column should have the same order of the cards. So the first column, I always choose spades, hearts, clubs, diamonds. Well, it's not really that important. The important thing is that it's black, red, or red, black, black, red, black. And the other important thing is that you have the same in all of the columns. So when I've chosen spades, hearts, clubs, diamonds, you have to do that in these two. So spades, hearts, clubs, diamond. Spades, hearts, clubs, diamond. And finally, spades, hearts, clubs, diamonds. Okay. The next row, you should have the same order as these, except it should start one further in. So it should be like this, hearts, clubs, diamonds, spades. And that should be all of this column. So hearts, clubs, diamonds, spades. Hearts, clubs, diamonds, and spades. And heart, club, diamond, spades. And the same with the next one, you should like take this one and put them in. So it should be clubs, diamonds, spades, hearts. So let's do that. Clubs, diamonds, spades, hearts. Clubs, diamonds, spades, hearts. And clubs, diamonds, spades, hearts. And finally, the last one will be just like the ones before. You take this one and you remove the top card and put it in the bottom. That will be diamonds, spades, hearts, clubs. Diamonds, spades, hearts, clubs. Okay, let's do that. Okay, next step, very easy. You take the top card from the piles in this order and then start over, always taking the top card and putting them on top of each other like this. Spade, and yeah, it's a good idea while you do it to actually keep track of that you get spades, hearts, clubs, diamond, spades, hearts, club, diamond, and so on all the way through the pile, because this will make sure that you haven't messed up somewhere. Hopefully it will make sure at least. So spades, hearts, clubs, diamonds, spades, hearts, clubs, diamonds, spades, hearts, clubs, diamonds, spades, hearts. Hearts, clubs, and finally diamonds. So now the cards are ordered just the way you want them. So this is how the cards should be before you start the trick. So now you meet the audience and you prepare and you you perform the trick. And this is actually pretty easy. There is no sleight of hand in this trick. It's actually totally automatic. You could, if you want to, and you believe that the audience will actually do exactly as you tell you, and tell them, you could actually have one of the audience do the trick for you, and it will work just the same. So, as I said, you had to shuffle the cards. So you can do this. Break the cards in two piles, put one on top of the other. And you can do this as many times as you like. So yeah, I think it looks good to do it sometimes because it will give the audience some sense that the cards are actually shuffled. You can do it just as many times as you like. It doesn't mess up anything. As long as you always remember it's two piles you divide it into. Never more than two piles. That might mess the trick up. So that's important. The next thing is you make these two piles to riffle shuffle together. Here there's one very important thing to remember. When you make the second pile, you count one card at the time. Never take more than one card. That will definitely ruin your card trick. And really, it doesn't matter how many cards you take, so that's why you can have the audience say, now is enough, or now is enough, and so on. It looks a bit more interesting if it's about half, but it don't have to be. It really doesn't matter how many. So let's just say that they're not exactly the same size, but who cares? It doesn't matter. So the next thing, a totally normal riffle shuffle. No tricks here, no sleight of hand, just a riffle shuffle. And now we have all we need to do. Now the cards are shuffled as they should be. And whenever you take the first two cards, you will get a black and a red card. The next two, a black and a red. 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 And it will be like that actually all the way through the pile. But you also have, if you take the first four cards, there'll be one of each suit. If you take the next four cards, there'll be one of each suit. And the next four card will be one of each suit, and so on. And again, all the way through the deck, we have one of each suit every time. The final thing is, if you take 13 cards, you will get one of each number. I'm not going to show you this in detail. I showed you that in the trick. So you can do that also all the way through. If you take the first 13, the next 13, the next 13, and the last 13. So what I did was I took two cards, an even number of times, because then I had taken a whole number of four cards. So then I could just start by taking four cards after that. But it's hard to keep track if you are at an even a whole number of 13s through the deck, which is why for the 13 you usually start at the bottom, because you know it's the bottom 13 cards will have one of each number and the next 13 card will also, and so on. So that's actually all there is to the trick. I know it sounds very strange that this is the case, but it works. It works every time. And I suggest you try to do it yourself. Get a deck of cards, follow my instructions step by step, and you will see it works. So I hope you learned something from that. So this card trick here is actually a very mathematical card trick. It's a mathematical principle called Gilbreath principle that's behind the trick. And you can probably look it up on the web and see lots of other examples of tricks using it. It is a well-known trick and used by many illusionists and card tricksters or whatever you call them. And well, I've for a long time had an interest in mathematical card tricks and mathematical theory of cards, how you handle cards, how you shuffle cards and so on. And I once met this really cool mathematician called Percy Diaconis, who actually proved how many times do you have to shuffle a card, a deck of cards of 52 different cards using the riffle shuffle method. See if I can do it here, like this. how many times should you do it like that before the cards are pretty good shuffled? So that's, yeah, that can actually be formalized mathematically. That sounds strange, but it can. So, well, he proved that. And my question for you is, how many times do you actually have to shuffle these cards using riffle shuffle before they're shuffled good enough?